So good afternoon. So welcome in Jülich. I think we can start maybe. Let me maybe start with briefly some housekeeping information. So what we will start to do is a simple registration. You got this sticky notes here, and you just write your name and put it on your shirt. And then by then we know your names. And by tomorrow there will be a regular batches. So I can. We can circulate it here, and there is also somewhere
pens.
Yeah, just write your name, and then it probably improves the communication when you know the names. So it's a simple registration.
But it's low cost registration.
You could just pass it on. Another point, Uli Schur. So Uli Schur is the chair of IPPN. Actually, you can see here the board, the chair, the vice chairs of IPPN. Uli Schur, he apologizes, he could not join, so he has an appointment right now and he could not do the introduction. And by that, so I'm happy to introduce you very briefly, give you an introduction about IPPN, so what IPPN is doing and also what the working group is doing and what we want to do within the next couple of days. And I hope you will have a fruitful, useful discussion, interaction with many of your colleagues about low-cost approaches. This is what the workshop is supposed to be about, and there is quite a lot of hands-on exercises, so that you not only just we will be exposed to presentations and just listen to talks, but you will also have an opportunity to do some experiments, small experiments, see the low-cost approaches, and put your hands on it and do some exercises with a few colleagues sitting in here in the room, and they will provide you some information and also give you some hands and work, do some small experiments with you. And by that, let me briefly introduce you to IPPN. So IPPN, in a few minutes, International Plant Phenotyping Network. It is an association aiming at integrating plant phenotyping community on a global scale. So why do we do it? So collaboration, as you can imagine, so it is actually a way of low-cost approaches. So networking, interacting with people saves in the end money. So you could understand it also as a cost-effective approach doing networking activities. But in the end, what we want to do is to bring users, researchers, developing, basically bring the phenotyping community together to interact, to have some productive outcome. You can imagine that plant phenotyping is a very interdisciplinary approach where you need many different people, experts coming from many different disciplines who need to talk together, interact with each other to advance the community at large. So when you look at plant phenotyping, so what happened within the last couple of years, so in 2008, so you have these academic centers which were interested in plant phenotyping. It's just a handful of institutions which were doing plant phenotyping. And within a couple of years, it's actually also by far not the latest version, but you can see quite a lot of things changed within a couple of years. A lot of projects, a lot of institutions involved in plant phenotyping. Please apologize if your institution is not in there. This is by far not complete, and it's still growing. The other thing is, there, apart from institutions involved in plant phenotyping, there is also a lot of networks. And all those networks, so you have kind of a national platforms. For example, what we have in Germany, which is also headed here by Jülich, is this German plant phenotyping network with the idea to establish infrastructure, phenotyping infrastructure for German customers, for German users of plant phenotyping approaches. The same goes, for instance, for the UK PPN, or UK United Kingdom plant phenotyping networks, or Phenom, the French network. And there are more and more networks popping up. This is the Austrian. This is the Australian. There is an Italian network. So there are quite some activities to build networks on a national level, to bring the national activities together, to develop as a community on a national level. Beyond the national level, there is also a lot of activities, for example, with networks like EPPN 2020, where this is also on European level, where in this project specifically access is provided to users, to different user groups, to phenotyping infrastructure. there is a project called Emphasis. Emphasis is, you can imagine that most of those projects, they have a limited time frame. So at some point they end and the project ends. Just after producing some useful results, the project ends. With Emphasis, we aim at long-term sustainable development of the pan-European infrastructure to make it available to different users across Europe. And there, of course, also this is North American plant phenotyping network, Latin American phenotyping network. So there are quite a lot of interest and approaches to interact with the community. And of course, you have also activities on a global scale related to specific crops, like the WIT initiative or IPPN, where we try to bring basically all those players together to interact just beyond their national or regional scale. Additionally, IPPN did a survey last year with quite a number of participants, and one of the results was that there is quite a lot of challenges, many common challenges, like field phenotyping. You can see also costs. So costs in general, cost of phenotyping is an important issue that's interesting for probably every one of us. Additionally, there are many different crops, so we are also there is quite a common interest in with respect to specific crops, and we are in many cases interested in the same crops or similar crops where we can use also the same approaches. So there is quite some need for interaction. There is no need to repeat errors of colleagues who did it a couple of years ago, and they know how to avoid those. It makes a lot of sense to discuss, to have an open communication discussion with many different players, and that was one of the. Those are the key reasons to found IPPN as International Plant Phenotyping Network as a legal entity and Global Academic Association. So the kickoff meeting was in November 2015 in Barcelona at the meeting, and IPPN was organized as a non-profit academic association based on a German law. The reason for that is the office is situated in Jülich in Germany, so it makes sense that it also based on German law. It makes the administrative issues much easier. That's more or less the only reason for this German law. The goals of IPPN, basically, how it's already addressed, is to integrate the regionally, globally fragmented activities, enable exchange of knowledge, information, provide networking platform to link the diverse groups, but also advise decision makers about the state of the art and future opportunities and limits of plant phenotyping. This is the members. We have currently over 30 IPPN members, which are the members are institutions, and it's still growing. And of course, IPPN is open for new members, so you are welcome to join IPPN anytime, and it's pretty easy and straightforward to join. You can ask me, or actually Carol is also sitting in the room, basically anyone from Jülich, how to join IPPN, and they can help you. What are we doing with IPPN? So what are the goals? As mentioned, so we want to be this central information hub, and IPPN has been already doing, or under this umbrella of IPPN, there were already symposia across the globe at different locations. We are supporting workshops, meetings on different topics, summer school, etc. Basically a workshop like we do now, but also establishing working groups. So working groups which focus on specific topics, address specific topics like affordable phenotyping, bring all the experts interested in this topic together to have an open discussion. And of course, we have a website with all this relevant information and relevant infrastructure databases on experts, on infrastructure, where you can find some information. And you are welcome to go on the website and see what's in there. And any comments from your sites are very welcome. And any improvements or idea what to add, what to remove, are very welcome. I mentioned already this international symposia, advertising already for 2018. So the next one will be in October 2018 in Adelaide, and you are very welcome to join this meeting. So it's the fifth International Plant Phenotyping Symposium. And from 2018, we aim at organizing this meeting on annual basis. And they will be basically across the globe, at different locations across the globe. What we also do right now, so very briefly about this ongoing recent activities, what we do. So we also, so far, I just mentioned that IPPN is an academic organization. We also try to include the industry. There has been a discussion during the last meeting in Mexico, which was the last international plant phenotyping symposium. There was a brainstorming with industry partners, how industry could be included or involved in IPPN, and this discussion is still ongoing. So what we developed is a roadmap, how industry could contribute, and the discussion is ongoing, and I hope that at some point there will be also industrial members, so we will, may have an industry section and the academic section which will interact with each other. Additionally, we also try to attract new partners from, in particular, Africa, for example, but also harmonization of events. It's you can imagine that there is kind of an over-workshopping right now going on in many different locations. So there are almost every month or almost every week there are workshops on plant phenotyping basically all across the globe. And in the end, we all need to decide what workshop is relevant for me, where can I go, and the resources are, of course, limited. So it makes a lot of sense to discuss with many different people organizing those meetings if we either merge those meetings or at least get informed what meetings take place at which time. So basically to avoid any conflict so that people can join the meeting they want, and also the organizers do not compete with each other. And of course, we also try to facilitate and initiate new working groups. Talking about working groups, so those are the working groups which are, some of them are already up and running, and others are in the process of being established. For example, also the affordable phenotyping, it's kind of already running, but doing the initial steps. But we also try to focus on root phenotyping, imaging, phenotyping under controlled environment, phenotyping technologies. This is one of the groups which is still looking at the more specific focus. Technologies sounds very broad. Data management, seed phenotyping, and modeling. So those are the groups which were suggested so far and are in the process of being established. And of course, what we also try to do is to look for links to other initiatives like WEED initiative. You may know it, the WEED initiative, or the DIFSIC initiative, which are also global initiatives with specific focus either on crops or genetic diversity. Briefly on affordable phenotyping, so what are we doing here? And here you can see some names. So the group was started, initiated. The first ideas came up by our colleagues from Jurich, Fabio, Mark, sitting here in the room, but also Luis, Gustavo from Argentina, and Valerio from New Zealand, who discussed what could this group do. And one of the results of this discussion was this workshop here. And the idea was the goals that development of new opportunities for low-cost phenotyping devices. So what are there any new opportunities we need to, it's actually needed to bring the community together to talk about new opportunities, what is needed, required, but also of course collect and share available knowledge, what do you use, and talk about your experience with these new devices. And of course, increase the availability and awareness of new phenotyping solutions or low-cost solutions. So those were the goals suggested by the people you could see in the previous slides. And the next steps, what we are trying to do is this operation of this working group. So the operation means that we will have kind of a, we could see this workshop as an inauguration of this working group. So the idea is to bring experts in low-cost phenotyping together and affordable phenotyping together and discuss relevant topics and how to address those topics. So in principle, we have the next 2.5 days time to discuss about all those relevant topics and how to address those. And in the next steps, the IPPN members, they will develop a plan, an operational plan, how to continue in the future, and there are different ways how to continue. For example, providing, organizing workshops, training schools. There is also some funds available within IPPN for travel grants. You can also write papers, establish new, also networking tools, something like a newsletter, blogs, different fora or Twitter to keep the communication going. But for that purpose, it's also, it's a kind of, the idea is that the working group is chaired by IPPN members, but it's open to the community. So it's actually up and running, or it can be only operational when the community is contributing and benefiting from that. So that, which means that we need kind of a critical mass that will contribute to the activities of the working group. And by that, let me briefly move to one point which I forgot. So there will be also a discussion on Wednesday on operation. One point to discuss would be how to operate this working group, what would be the topics you would like to have in there, how to include those topics, how would you like to be included, and so on. So it's an open discussion, and we would have almost the entire half a day of Wednesday to discuss, among others, also this issue. So, but what will we do within the next days? So today there will be a number of presentations, 9 or 10 different presentations. We have 2 invited guests, David Russo and Sotirios Tsafaritis, who will talk about, on the one hand, of imaging, but Sotirios will talk about machine learning approaches, and a number of other presentations will address topics, affordable phenotyping topics, different sensors that might be used. The basic idea is to initiate a discussion so that you learn what is available within the community, what can be used, and tomorrow, actually, there will be also a discussion, presentations by some company, colleagues from companies, and then in the afternoon there will be this hands-on exercises where you can also not only listen and see slides of these tools, but also put your hands on those and work and test something. And then on Wednesday there will be a discussion about this, basically about the hands-on exercises, operation and participation of the community within this activities. And of course, what we try to do is to start a challenge about affordable phenotyping. But about this challenge, maybe we can talk on Wednesday and explain you some more detail. What I forgot to mention is there was, according to the plan, the idea was to have today a discussion at 5 o'clock, already start a discussion, open discussion about how to operate phenotyping, what is actually affordable phenotyping. We will move it to Wednesday, so we have quite some time for this discussion on Wednesday, and today we will do a short tour with you after at 5:30. Mark and me would go with you to the greenhouses and give you a short tour so that you can see what we also do in Jülich and see some of our phenotyping approaches. Last but not least, it's actually the most important point, so key people. So I would like to mention the key people who are involved in organizing here everything. So Carol Richards, you probably communicated with her per email. So Carol is she's not sitting here right now, but she's the person when you need something, then you probably ask Carol. Carol is pretty good in organizing, helping you with whatever is needed. Then also Mike and Manuela, they are sitting in the secretariat here. They are also helpful in whatever organizational things you need. Danny is our IT expert. He's also recording the session. So the idea is that we also record the talks. We, as mentioned already, so we try to open up to the community and also provide the talks. You agree that we can put the talks on a website, maybe also on YouTube channel, and open it up to the community. There are some forms just for the speakers. If you agree that your talk will be presented on a website, please sign a short form that you agree with that, and then it's fine. Who else did I know? So Uli Stegelmann, Andreas Avarez, they are also in the IT team supporting Danny. And of course we have in particular Fabio and Mark, the key persons behind the scientific content of this meeting. In particular, Mark put a lot of effort of preparing all these hands-on exercises. He will also give a talk today. And tomorrow he will be the key person in organizing all these hands-on exercises. And of course Gustavo and Luis, they came from Argentina and will also give you some hands-on exercises on I think thermography, right? And of course, give us a talk. And by that, I will not waste your time anymore. And I think we can move on to the first speaker, unless you have any questions, any questions on IPPN or any other topics you are interested in.